regardless of what anyone tells you. Grilling baby back ribs doesn't have to take all day. In today's video, I'm gonna take you through the entire process for how we're gonna grill some hot and fast 2-hour, 2-zone baby back ribs that are not only gonna be flavorful, but I'm gonna show you some specific techniques that you can use to ensure they're both tender and juicy as well. If that sounds good to you, let's dive in. We're going with our standard 2 chimney starters for today's grilling session. I'll be using Kingsford Original Charcoal Briquettes. If you need some additional help with using chimney starters, I'll drop a card up above and leave a link down in the description below to a video that's dedicated to showing you how to use chimney starters. Here's a rundown of the seasonings we'll be using today. Some extra virgin olive oil, some Lowry's seasoned salt, some black pepper, some onion powder, and some garlic powder. After rinsing and patting dry each slab with some paper towels, I'm going to remove the membrane on each slab. In my experience, I found that removing the membrane allows the seasonings to penetrate the meat a bit better on the backside of the slab. Now we're ready to rub each one down with some extra virgin olive oil. The olive oil is going to prevent moisture from escaping as we subject our meat to some relatively high grilling temperatures. Now we're ready to add our dry seasonings. For convenience, I've added all my dry ingredients to this shaker you see right here. And as I shake on the seasonings with one hand, I'm going to use my other hand to really massage the seasonings into the meat to help ensure it fuses well and starts to tenderize those muscle fibers. Our coals are now ready, so let's go ahead and get them spread out. We'll be configuring our grill today to have 2 zones. Zone number 1 is going to be on the right side. Here we will have our charcoal, and zone number 2 is going to be on the left side, and we will not have charcoal in this zone. Setting our grill up like this will give us maximum versatility, and we'll be able to cook direct, indirect, and smoke during today's grilling session. We've got our grates cleaned and lubed, so first, we're going to put our slabs directly over the coals meat side down for them to get some direct heat action. This is going to allow us to sear the outside of the ribs and begin building our texture and color. And also, this allows the ribs to begin absorbing some of that intense smoky charcoal flavor that's going to be its most intense when the meat is sitting directly over the coals.
For today's grilling session, I'm going with my standard vent configuration. We'll set the intake vent to be wide open, and we'll set the exhaust stack to be set to about halfway. If we need to make any adjustments, we'll make them to the exhaust stack. But honestly, I very seldom make any adjustments at all to my vents. Through a lot of trial and error, I found that my grill drafts and performs the best with this vent configuration. So I just like leaving this alone. And if we need to make any adjustments for the sake of temperature, I'll make these to either the meat placement and fuel source. If you want more details on my philosophy for maintaining temperature on a charcoal grill, I'll drop a card here to a video for you to check out.
We just put this meat on the grill, and since we're going direct and cooking directly over the coals for the beginning of this cook, I'm not going anywhere. I'm gonna stay right here by this grill and keep an eye out, and I'm gonna be on the watch for any flare-ups, and I'm trying to listen for any aggressive sizzles, but so far so good. So let's let this meat go for about 10 minutes or so, and we'll be right back.
It's been about 10 minutes. Now let's go in and take a look at our meat. Okay, I definitely like what I'm seeing here. I like the color, I like the texture. I think we're off to a good start. Let's go ahead and flip all four slabs, and then we'll let them go another 10 minutes or so, bone side down. It's been about 10 minutes. Now we're ready to move our slabs over to zone number two. However, before we do that, I'm gonna add a drip pan below our meat, and I'm gonna add about 2 cups of water and a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar to the pan. In order to maximize our space on the grill, I'm gonna use my rib rack. Whenever I use my rib rack, I like to spray it down first with some non-stick cooking spray. This is gonna help prevent the bark of the ribs from sticking to the rack. And while we're here, let's also give the ribs a little spritz. I'm using my all-purpose spritzer here, which consists of 3 parts water, 1 part apple cider vinegar, and 1 tablespoon of soy sauce. Let's also add a few chunks of hickory to zone number one. And to help ensure we get a nice clean smoke, I like to keep the lid open until I see the chunks break out into flames. That way I know they're burning cleanly and not just smoldering.
So we've just got our meat positioned in zone number two. So we're gonna be cooking both indirect and we're gonna be smoking now for this portion of the cook. We'll probably let this go for about 50 or 60 minutes before we go back in and check. Now currently our temperature gauge is showing about 400 degrees. And I know this is probably a bit higher than some of you are used to cooking ribs at, or the temperature at which you've seen other people cook ribs at. But in my experience, I found that this is the perfect temperature for me. It's the perfect temperature as long as you don't neglect moisture. And think about some of the things we've done along the way to help us not only protect the moisture that's already in the ribs, but also introduce additional moisture into our meat as well. Remember that olive oil we put on there when we were prepping the meat? The purpose of that was to help protect the meat from losing any moisture during the cook. We also added that drip tray. We took on half a pan of aluminum tray, put it under our meat. Not only is it there to collect the grease to make cleanup easier, but we added some water and apple cider vinegar there so that tray can steam a little bit and introduce moisture into the ribs as well. And an additional thing we have our spritzer out here. We got our spray bottle that has apple cider vinegar, water, and soy sauce, and we'll spritz as needed along the way as well. So definitely don't neglect moisture when you're cooking at higher temperatures like this. And there's yet another technique I'll show you a bit later that we're gonna use to help these ribs reclaim some of the moisture as well. So definitely, you can do it. You can cook at higher temperatures like this, but remember, don't forget moisture, and definitely try out some of the techniques you're seeing here today.
It's been about 50 to 60 minutes, and now let's open her up and take a look at our ribs. I like what I'm seeing here. These ribs are definitely showing signs of cooking nicely. A few things I like to look for in my ribs, in addition to checking internal temperature, our meat pullback on the bone. I want to see some flex in the slab, and I want to measure the amount of bone twist. So I'll put my tongs at like that centermost bone and twist it a little bit, and based on the amount of give or resistance in the bone twist, that'll let me know how tender the ribs are and how much longer they may have to cook. So all of these are signs to let you measure how far along your ribs are and how tender they are. And by what I'm seeing here, I think these ribs are ready to be wrapped. So what I'm going to do now is to wrap each slab tightly in some aluminum foil so that it can tenderize, and this will also help us introduce more moisture into each slab. We'll let these go wrap for about 30 minutes or so, and then we'll come back and check them out.
Been about 30 minutes or so since I wrapped them in foil. I'm just coming in to check right now. Temperature gauge is showing 320 degrees at this point.
Now let's go in and get an internal temp on these ribs. I like for the internal temperature on each slab to be at about 205 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's check each slab, and it looks like each one is temping and coming back at around the 205 mark. So let's go ahead and get this meat off the grill. So our meat is off the grill now. We've let it sit on the counter for about 10 to 15 minutes to let our meat rest and to let those juices redistribute in the meat. So now we're ready to go ahead and open up the foil and start cutting up each slab. Oh yeah, that's what I want to see. As I look at this slab, I'm seeing all the signs of a nice tender slab. I see the pullback, the flex is here, and that moisture looks good. So after cutting through the first slab, I can tell these are right where I want them to be with respect to tenderness. The knife is slicing through the meat with little to no resistance. So let me go ahead and get the rest of these slabs sliced up, and I'll see you at the dinner table.
Southern style baked beans with your bell pepper, onions, coleslaw, and I'm about to dig in. I'm a little late coming to the table. I see Judah over here putting in work.
How I text you?
Good.
Good. See that bone, cleaning up bones over here. And Noah over here behind me putting in work. How you doing, Noah? You all right? Yeah. Okay, I see you. All right, y'all, I'm about to dig in. Let's go.
All right, y'all, let's dig in. First, going in on this this rib right here, y'all. Can y'all see that? That's how it's looking. Show y'all a cross-section of it. That right there. All right, y'all, I'm just going in. Wow.
Daddy.
Effortless, y'all.
Daddy.
Effortless. Yeah, babe. It's good? First of all, the color is good. I mean, the color, y'all saw that. Color is what I want it to be. It's tender. It's just right there. Just right there. We left it on that foil wrap just long enough. It's not fall off the bone. It's just effortless pluck. Right? See that? Mmm. That's it right there. Flavor's good. Man, when you do that, when you do that two-zone technique like that, it's like you taste the direct action. You got that char on there. You got that charcoal flavor. But then you taste the hickory. And then it has that oven roasted taste. So man, this is delicious, y'all. Mmm. Go in one more time. Mmm. I'm gonna split them right here too, y'all. Watch it split. Just like that, baby. Mmm. Delicious. Two zone baby back ribs, man. Give it a try. You don't have to cook ribs all day. That's what I'm trying to show y'all in this video and some of my other videos. You do not have to cook ribs for hours upon hours to get a good product. Just go in, follow the steps we showed you today, and y'all let me know how it turns out down in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope this video helped you out. If it did, hit that subscribe button and click that bell so anytime we drop a new video, you'll be the first to know. Hit that like button and leave me some comments. I'd love to hear from you. If you're interested in any of the products we used in today's video, we'll leave some links down below. Hope you have an awesome day, and thanks for watching.